Hi, I'm Mark. If you recently bought a Genesis GV70, you may have received a front license plate bracket, and you may be challenged as to where that bracket is attached to the car. It's not an easy thing to decide where it goes. So let's look at the front of this. This grille is a very nice grille, and the bracket should hook on this part of the grille. Do not take the bracket down here, because all of this here is part, it has wires behind it, and this is part of your adaptive cruise control. It estimates how fast the cars in front of you are going. It has the radar thing. It keeps your car a certain distance from the cars in front of it. I was first tempted to put it down here, but that would have blocked my adaptive cruise control and radar. So I put it up here, and when you get this, there's these circles, and they sort of stick out on the back of this, and it's sort of confusing as to where they go. At first I thought, well, maybe they go inside these, like here, here, and here, and here, and then you put the screw in, and then the little circular thing expands and hooks on this grill. That doesn't work. Then I tried hooking it directly to this grill, but that doesn't work because the slats on these rounded parts go horizontally, so they won't hook on this sort of diagonal type of grill. Then I realized that behind the grill is sort of a soft plastic piece. You can reach back there and feel it. And the plastic piece is shaped somewhat like what's up here. So in other words, the plastic piece that's behind this grill is narrower at the top and wider at the bottom. And you'll notice that this plate has an arrow in it, so that has to go up. You have to have this bracket in the with the arrow up. And the only reason that you have to have that is because the plastic piece behind it wouldn't attach properly because it is in this shape. So if you don't have the arrow up, you're not gonna hook that in. Now let's look at what screws I selected down here. So they give me this screw to begin with. This screw is way too short. You cannot hook it into this bracket. I happen to have this at home. It's sort of like a machine screw, self-tapping, has a washer on it. I was thinking of putting that in, but the diameter of this is just a little bit thick. You'll notice it's thicker than this screw here. And I was afraid of ripping out the little circular thing that's in there and tearing it. So I decided on this, which is about the same thickness, this, or if you want to call it a diameter, this is about the same thickness as that one. It might be even a little smaller. So there's no way when you screw this into the hole that goes into that bracket that it's going to rip out that hole. So I used this, and then I held the bracket with one finger while I screwed it in at the top. Now make sure you don't screw the screw into your finger, because this is pointed and it's a little longer. You could actually get by with one a little shorter, but this is just what I had. Hold the bracket, the plastic flange at the back as you screw it in, and hold it on all four. Now when you're done, this is holding pretty nicely everywhere. And it's above the area where the radar is for the adaptive cruise control. Now, they give you these two screws right here that are what you use to hook on the plate. Notice they don't have a washer. They're the same screws as your back plate has. So you put these. Now, it so happens in my state that these two holes match up. This is the actual size of my license plate. I'm using this as a pretend license plate. I put these up here. They already have a small hole in them. You can start it with your hand, or you can use, you can even put it right on the tool and use it. You get it started in here, and it goes right in here to the top of the bracket. This is another reason you want to follow the upward sign of the bracket, so that you have this in here, and you put this in on this one, and it so happens my bit is magnetic, so it will hold this in, I'm lining it up here properly. I put that in, and voila, I'm not gonna tighten this because it's not my real license plate, but you tighten these in all the way and your license plate will be snug against here. So this should be your way of finding out how to hook the bracket on the front of a Genesis GV70, because it's likely the dealer didn't hook it on for you when you bought the car. And they recommend if you call Genesis that you take it into the dealer. But that means making an appointment, driving into the dealer, dealing with all the time involved. And it just seems like if you have some screws at home, you might have to go to a hardware store and buy some that are right, that you can do it yourself and not worry about it. So thanks so much. This is Mark, and good luck with your Genesis front license plate holder.